Is there anything you're sort of looking to improve upon? I know you have a day off tomorrow, so you might do a little bit of practice.
Yeah, obviously practicing tomorrow. I guess just work on my serve and maybe just coming in more to the net. But overall, I think I played really well all three sets, so I wouldn't really change too much.
Now, you've also mentioned you haven't taken much time off this year. You've been training pretty hard. So, with the day off in Toronto, will you get a chance to maybe go see a movie, relax a little bit?
I don't know. I mean, it depends on my schedule. But yeah, I mean, I went sightseeing. Not sightseeing, but I just went around the city like 2 days ago. So I've seen Toronto, and hopefully, maybe tomorrow night I can do something.
Okay, well, you keep winning. You'll get to see Toronto for the rest of the week. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Just wants to see center court. She doesn't need to see the rest of the city right now. First top five win, James. What did you learn about Sonya Kennett today?
I mean, more of the same. She is absolutely rock solid mentally. Just toughs it out. As Chanda said, experience for Ash Barty in that first set, and maybe that can be a factor when you're playing the number one player in the world. You can falter a little. What did I do? What can I do even better? And change your game sometimes to the more experienced player's credit. And she didn't do that at all. She stayed within herself, kept ripping that backhand, taking it to Ash Barty. And as Shannon said, she was reading her serve better. And she said she needs to work on her serve a little bit more tomorrow. But it looked pretty good to me in that second and third sets.
She is such a fighter, Chanda. I mean, you can't put her as an underdog really against anybody anymore.
No, I mean, and she has the confidence with the wins that she's gotten under her belt. And, you know, you just, that's something you can't get in practice. You only get that by doing it under pressure, coming through those big moments. And you look at the fact that Kennan had lost all previous three meetings between the two, but she got better and better in each match. That last match at Roland Garros this year, she went three sets, had some opportunities. So I think she's gaining confidence, and she believes in herself. She believes in her game. She is such a good competitor, as well as being solid from the ground. Her backhand is money. You know, she's got a lot of potential, and she's still growing with her game. So there's a lot to look forward to in terms of her.
Every week, it's another young American that's doing something special. 20 years old, Kennan beats the world number one. And that means, by the way, we could have a new world number one. Here are the scenarios with Ash Barty going down. Naomi Osaka, if she beats Tatiana Maria tomorrow, that means we will have a new number one. It could also be Karolina Pliskova. She needs to reach at least the semifinals or win the title if Osaka reaches the semis. By the way, if Osaka plays Pliskova, the winner of that match is the new world number one. So I ask you, James, and then Chanda, who leaves Toronto as the world number one?
Well, since yesterday I said Barty, I'm going to have to change my answer now. It could still happen. I'm not so confident in it anymore. I'm going to go with Naomi Osaka. And I have no idea why. I just think that's what I'm going to go with. And I've been wrong before, so this time I'm throwing out all the data and the research. I'm just going to go with Naomi Osaka, go with my gut this time.
All right, Chanda?
Yeah, I think that's kind of the least risky answer. Okay. When you look at the fact that, you know, she's got to get through her second round against Tatiana Maria minimally, and she should, although that could be a tricky match for Osaka. I mean, you just never know at the end of the day, but I think Osaka's probably a pretty good bet if we're going to change from Barty.
All right. We're going least risk